Hello viewers, in this program today we will see in detail use and operation of an oscilloscope. First of all, switch on power of CRO. See indicator. Wait for 20 seconds until the beam or spot appear on the screen. Vary the intensity control if beam or spot is dim or not appearing on the screen. The setting of intensity control may affect the correct focus of the display. Watch here. How will be necessary to reset the focus control when the intensity control is changed. If the beam is not in parallel with the graticule horizontal line, then align the horizontal beam with the help of trace rotation control. Using proper screwdriver. This probe is used to give input signal to oscilloscope. Connect one terminal of the probe to the input of CRO. The other end of the probe into calibration terminal and check one volt peak to peak signal of approximately 1 kHz frequency. To check one volt peak to peak signal, first of all vary volt division and adjust the signal amplitude. And by varying time division, adjust the number of cycles of the signal as shown here. These are two squares in vertical scale of CRO. And the position of volt division now is at 0.5 volt position. Here, time division is at 0.5 millisecond and one full cycle of the signal is occupying 2 divisions in the horizontal scale. Verify 1 volt peak to peak signal amplitude, put the measured values in this formula. inverse of wavelength is frequency. Put the measured values of the wavelength to verify 1 kilohertz signal. Remove the probe from calibration tunnel and see horizontal beam. By varying the vertical position control, the beam can be moved up or down. And by varying the horizontal position control, the beam can be moved to left
or right.
AC-DC push button switch is to select input coupling. The depressed state is for DC coupling, the out state is for AC coupling. Connect AC signal from signal generator to the input of CRO.
With AC coupling, the DC component of the input signal is cut off and the AC component alone is displayed.
With DC coupling, both components are displayed. Here, this signal is shifted in DC position of the switch. See again. But no shifting in this AC signal because of no DC component. This bowl division knob is a dual knob. The upper knob is for one bowl division variation for full rotation. The lower knob selects the vertical sensitivity. From 5 millibolt per division to 5 volts per division in 10 ranges, and the upper one for one division vertical deflection with the variable knob set. Watch the amplitude variation in the signal with these knobs. By varying the vertical position control, the beam can be moved up or down. The pulled position gives 5 times magnification. Region and delay time knob is also of dual type. The larger knob is selectable from 0.5 millisecond per division to 0.2 microsecond per division in 20 ranges. The time division switch selects calibrate horizontal sweep rate for the internal sweep generator. The smaller knob is for delay time division. You can bring required number of cycles of given signal on the CRO screen with the help of this knob. The lower portion of this dual knob is for horizontal positioning. And the upper one for sweep variable. By this upper knob, number of cycles can be varied between locked position to unlocked position. This is a double beam CRO. The instrument operates at a single channel oscilloscope. With channel 1 with its bowl division position control and channel selector. Similarly for channel 2. See the signals of channel 1 and channel 2. When both channels are depressed at the same time, instruments operate as a dual channel oscilloscope.
Dual beam oscilloscope has the advantage of measuring phase difference between the signal of different frequency, wave shape and amplitude.
Eight knob is for measurement of algebraic addition of the channel 1 and channel 2 signals. Channel 1 and channel 2 controls do not have independent effects. With XY switch, the instrument operates as an XY display with the external sweep signal as needed in case of TV alignment.
To display a stationary pattern on CRT screen, displayed signal itself or a signal which has the fixed time relationship with respect to displayed signal is required to be put in the triggering circuit.
Polarity knob can inverse the signal applied to CRO. When this TV button is pressed, a TV sync separator is connected to the triggering circuit to extract vertical or horizontal sync pulses from a TV signal. When this 5-time magnification knob is pushed, the displayed signal is spread 5 times in horizontal position. When this knob is pulled out, the vertical amplification gain is increased by 5 times, means the vertical sensitivity is increased by 5 times. In pressed position, it acts as a vertical positioning of the signal or beam. Signal generator is required for the measurement of voltage, frequency, and phase difference. The input impedance of this oscilloscope is 1 mega ohm, with the capacitance approximately 25 picofarad in parallel. When 10:1 probe is used, the impedance is increased to 10 mega ohm, with approximately 20 picofarad in parallel. When the probe is used, although signal level is attenuated to 1/10, but the loading effect on the major signal is greatly reduced. This figure shows the internal view of the probe. The outer shield part is always grounded to prevent induction noise.
To measure AC voltage, which has no DC component, or to measure AC component alone of a signal which has the DC component superimposed on it.
A signal generator with its input lead is required for measurement of voltage. Connect output of signal generator to the input of CRO and set AC-DC selector switch to the AC position. Set the volt division knob, which will allow the signal displayed on the CRO within limit. And note the position of this knob. Several cycles on the screen can be obtained by varying time division knob. Before commencing voltage measurement, set variable attenuator knob to calibration position in locked position. Peak position of the one cycle is coincided with the vertical center line using horizontal positioning control knob, and align signal peak with the horizontal line using vertical positioning control knob. Read volt division factor, which is at 0.5 volt. Count number of volt division, which are 4.6. Read probe attenuation factor, which is at 10. The formula used for calculation of the voltage is peak to peak voltage is equal to volt division factor into number of volt division into probe attenuation factor. As per calculation, the peak-to-peak voltage is 23 volt. Similarly, we can measure the DC voltage by measuring the shift of the trace with respect to the original position. The voltage of the different types of wave shapes can also be measured in the similar way by counting volt division position, number of square in vertical scale and by noting probe attenuation factor.
For frequency measurement, you have to measure wavelength and the distance between two consecutive points of a signal which are in same phase of motion is called wavelength, and the inverse of wavelength is frequency.
Here, after setting time division position for at least 2 cycles on the CRO screen, align the peak position of the signal with vertical scale. Count the number of square on horizontal scale and position of time division switch. Horizontal scale reading is 4 division and the time division switch in 2 millisecond position. Wavelength is equal to time division factor into number of division. As per calculation, frequency of the AC signal is 125 Hz. The other way of calculating frequency is with the help of Lesage's figure. For this, 2 signals are needed. One is of known frequency and another one of unknown frequency, which is to be calculated. Because of large variety of oscilloscope, it is impossible to discuss the control of each make and model. The control and the connectors are not always found in the same location and in the same forms on all.
I hope this program has given you an overview of oscilloscope operation. In future program, we will go in more detail. Thank you.